time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much for you, still more. Speed your love to me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Wait for me, I'll be coming home. Wait for me.
Greetings and salutations of peace. I'm your brother, the Rastafari Ital Ayman I. Welcome to Lord of the New Fire. Barack Hussein Obama is the first ever black president of these United States of America. Some ignorant Negroes will jump Jim Crow and say John Hanson, among about four others, were before Obama. But fact is, Hanson was the president of the Continental Congress. He was elected in 1779 as a delegate to the Continental Congress. He really had no power. He was just an elected man in Congress. His title was President of the Continental Congress. And this Hanson was not even a black man. Some historian in the year, in it was about the 1930s, if I can recall correctly, used a photograph of Senator John Hanson of Liberia to support the claim that John Hanson was the same John Hanson of George Washington times, and that he was a black man. I set the record straight here for you. The question we should be asking is, why at this time does United States of America need a black president? That's what we should be concentrating on, is asking ourselves and others, why does the United States at this particular time need a black president? we all know that America, despite the illusion, is still very much a racist entity. We can all intuit the psychological fear embedded in the very cells of the average black man. It's like seeing a police, no one has did anything wrong, but your blood runs cold. Everyone freezes automatically. No one will say the white man is a devil when you know he is responsible for all the ills of the world. Yeah, there are a few good ones. I even know that. You know, there are a few. There's always going to be a few good ones. There are also black devils too. People are demons too, you know. And you were once this man's slave. Now you got to remember, you were his property. And you say that's in the past now. A lot of you say that. And our children grow up not knowing the history of their race. It's Thanksgiving, and I haven't seen my son all day. He's 15. His mother's not around. He's 15. And he's been at the home of his white friends ever since early this morning, around about 10 o'clock. But I don't get into any kind of negativity. I'm not going to tell him not to associate with his white friends. I mean, he live and he's learned. I think that's the best teacher, is just let him learn on his own. She homeschools her children just like I homeschool my children. So this better be a learning experience for him. So I'm not going to stunt his growth. He don't have any younger. All his brothers and sisters are older, so they're like living on their own, so he don't have any children to play with, and there's not many that many children around. So I let him go ahead on and experience life. Okay, so much for that. I'm just not gonna get into arguing with him and tell him don't do this and don't do that, because I taught him when he was young, so I instill certain ethics in him, and he'll come to his senses when it's time. That's how I feel about a lot of you. Okay, I'm gonna let that go now. We hear of occupying Wall Street, occupying this and that. It all started like the domino effect from the protests in Egypt when the uprising started. They overthrew the government. Everybody caught on. So it's written for us, and I want you to hear me good. We won't join the fighting. We will let all our troubles, all our worries, like a breeze through our fingers, slip away. And that's from the album Hotter Than July, song Master Blaster Jammin' by the Blind Seer, Brother Stevie Wonder. Why can't we do something real like occupy Stevie Wonder's headquarters named Black Bull out there in Northern California? That we break through the wall of the clandestine La Rota security group who surrounds him, that reality has no audience. This is what we should be doing instead of following a fleeting illusion, occupying Wall Street and all that crazy stuff. Babylon's gonna fall, and it is falling, but we gotta find a way to survive. Okay, the Master Blaster Jammin', you heard me talk about it for the last 4 years here on YouTube, was designed that we spread the word of the urgency of this hour. This will be the esoteric signal for Nibiru. Like the prophets of old who cried out unto the Lord scientifically, even the sun stood still for some of them, I've read. The seven trumpet soundings around Jericho walls, surely we want to be among those not partaking of the God's wrath which is being currently poured out over the world. For I have said many times of it being written in scriptures that when two or more gather in the name of truth, and it's written the two or more gather in the name of Jesus, he's in your midst. But I put it like this: when two or more gather in the name of truth, power is in their midst. In another place it is also written that we see that when the children of Israel means children of the light, you know, Jacob had this dream on a stone. He was resting on a stone out there in the field after a hard day working, had his dream on, and he was taking up this ladder, meaning he went up to Nibiru, up to the mothership there, and God gave him a new name. He became Israel, and his followers became the children of Israel. So Israel represents that light called Nibiru, or that bright and shining light called Sirius. So, it is written, when the children of the light cried out in unison, the gods remembered the covenant. And what is this covenant? I tell you, one of my final times. It is written that when it became time for the pole shift, like it is now and like it was in the time of Noah, the gods will send us help unto our safety. That's the meaning of the gods remembered the covenant. When we cry out, Master Blaster Jam, you know, when the Muslims, when the Muazzin calls the prayer, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, everybody come to prayer. They line up side by side, regardless of spiritual station, regardless of social station. The old bum lines up with the rich man. They forget all their differences, and everybody cry out to the Lord in unison and cup their ears in a waiting for a reply. It's the same thing. That's symbolic, but the Master of Blaster Jamming is a real call to prayer. Allahu Akbar! If there's anyone out there in the sound of my weak voice and still in their sound mind, still upon off ship earth, let him come forward now. It's that time we have all been awaiting for. You know, many are against, I know I'm skipping around here, but just listen closely, listen attentively for a while here. Many are against Obama, but I tell you, he's for a sign of this time in which we live. The Milky Way is about 100 to 150,000 light years across in diameter. It is estimated that the Milky Way completes a revolution in about 200 to 220 or even 250 million years. So 200, 220, 226, and some even say 250 million years. This number, the one number we should notice is the number 220 divided by 12 equals 18.3 million years since the sun's birth. It has circled the galaxy about 18 times since its birth. Our focus here is the number 220. As Obama, first black president, comes 220 years after George Washington, the first president, a white man. A revolution in time has been completed, as symbolized in the 220 million year revolution of the Milky Way. This is a galactic communications from the voice of God, the galactic core, named Hunabku by the ancient Maya, the abode of the gods. And the creative life force itself, Obama, is its sign on earth at this time. You're now in tune on the one, the force itself. At this time, we call it the Master Blaster Jam. As the Master Bob say, I don't want to wait in vain for your love. I tell you, I ask you, speed your love to me. We need your support. Peace. I am your brother, the Rastafari. I talk, I'm an eye. One love.
Why is it so hard for us?